A lot of people pretending that they loved Lou Reed this weekend.
Is that what it is? A lot of people pretending.
Yes, I'm sorry, yes.
I hear you.
Unless you're Ronnie B and a handful of other people, stop pretending Lou Reed was so great in your life.
Yes.
Stop it.
Now, you bring up a good point.
I know like two songs, I think.
Yeah.
Walk on the Wild Side and I'll go Sweet Jane. Do you know a third Lou Reed song?
No.
The Satellite song, right?
Yeah.
That's him, isn't it?
That him?
I guess.
Is it?
Supposedly.
Satellite of Love? Yeah, that's
Lou Satellite
Reed.
Of Love? Is that the one Ron Perry played at the end? That's a good song.
It's Ronnie's song. Ronnie will have a lot to say about Lou Reed. Ron Bennington knows Lou Reed.
Listen to this.
He just talked.
He talked. He didn't sing at all. He's tone deaf. Things like that dry sweet Jane.
I like the songs that I've heard. I like this.
I like to watch. No, and nobody said he was a great singer. I just heard this morning on the news. Oh, he was amazing. He had a great voice. Shut up. Shut up.
All I'm saying, there are people out there, but in general, everyone jumped on the old bandwagon and made believe that they loved Lou Reed more than they did.
Exactly.
That's all I'm saying.
This is a good song.
He was very influential, I guess. I don't even know.
I guess people liked him.
Velvet Underground was a huge influential band.
I think it's very hip to say that you liked him and were influenced
by
him.
That's all I'm trying to say.
Yeah.
That's it.
The early 70s, I was reading something about him until the early 70s. A couple of his albums in the early 70s were supposed to be brilliant, but you know, I never got into him.
Yeah.
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 This song I like and the other two.
I heard he was brilliant. I don't know why, and I don't really know a lot of his songs except for the hits that I played on the radio over the years. And did you know that he married Laurie Anderson in 2008?
Who's she?
She's that performance artist that had that one hit way in the, I think in the early to mid 80s, Superman.
What?
I think it was even on MTV, the video.
Really? Let me see.
You know the song and you're not going to like it. This thing?
Oh. Of course. Of course he married her.
Lou Reed married. You remember this?
I remember the. Oh, imagine these two assholes talking to each other tonight.
That's just mean.
Fuck this.
Oh. She's a performance artist. And this was on MTV.
I do remember this.
You do, right? So they got married in 2008.
Well, I was waiting for a good video to play.
No, this is all it is.
Yeah. How fucking annoying is this?
Nice.
No, it's not.
You don't want to dance this?
No.
I do.
Doesn't get much better. How much longer? Yeah.
7 minutes. 7.5 minutes.
Holy fuck.
And it never kicks in.
I'm not home right now, but if you want to leave a message, just start talking at the sound of the tone.
Oh, God. Pretentious fucking horse shit.
Hello? This is your mother. Are you there? Are you coming home?
This is like a torture.
I don't mind the beat behind it, but what she's putting in front of it is fairly awful.
Is anybody home?
What is that?
Well, you don't know me.
Oh, she's got a light in her mouth now. This is great.
Do you think this is just music to get high to?
Yes, this is some type of drug shit.
The beauty of a radio show. There's got to be one lousy fucking person out there that could explain this to us. What is performance art? Why is it important? And why do we know the name Laurie Anderson?
Or I didn't know her name.
Well, you know the song, though, from MTV.
See that other performance art piece over the weekend of the lady that got jizzed on the train? And she has a sign about how she got jizzed on a train.
Right.
And then she stands in front of the train with the sign and does a performance piece.
Ugh.
Oh, it's terrible.
performance art's weird. Like, a lot of them are just people who aren't good enough to perform in clubs.
Yes.
And they, instead of admitting, wow, I'm just not good enough, they make it look like they're such geniuses and nobody right. got them. And then there are performance artists that are bringing something that's really different and brilliant to the table that, honestly, crowds don't really...
Right.
It's hard to sell to regular crowds, so...
I don't mind this, but I wouldn't, like, search it out, if that makes sense. I wouldn't go see Laurie Anderson.
Not only do I mind this, it hurts me. It's a physical pain that it's inflicting. Like, there's no reason to be this annoyed with something that's
unimportant.
To, yes.
All right. This... Or Yoko Ono.
Oh, you got to take this.
Okay, good.
But yeah. I would take anything over yeah. that Yoko shit.
This didn't ruin the Beatles.
Yeah. Oh, Dirty Boulevard I know as well. Thank you, Pat, Staten Island. Talking about Lou Reed right now. We know Dirty Boulevard.
I don't know.
Well.
Dirty Boulevard.
Give us a little Dirty Boulevard. So anyway, Lou Reed married Laurie Anderson. I did not know that.
Go for him.
Reading up on Lou Reed this weekend.
And then, he was a dick, too.
Well...
From people who had met him.
Sure. Yeah. That has been said.
That he was.
And he got a new liver in May.
Yeah, how'd that work out for him?
Well, at the time, Laurie Anderson said he was dying. He needed the liver.
Yeah. So,
what did he die of, by the way?
They're not saying yet.
I thought I heard on the news this morning it was complications from the...
From the liver
from
thing?
The liver. Oh, okay.
Infection.
What, did he, like, have fucking hep or something?
And that's an update. This is a cool song. No? Turn this up.
No, more talking.
He's got nine brothers and sisters. They're brought up on their knees. It's hard to run when a coat hanger beats you on the thighs. Pedro dreams of being older and killing the old man. But that's a slim chance. He's going to the boulevard. He's going to end up on the dirty boulevard. He's going out.
He's going out
to the dirty,
dirty boulevard.
Boulevard.
He's going down to the dirty boulevard.
This isn't singing.
This room costs $2,000. I'm sure if you listen to Ron and Fez later, you will hear the most obscure fucking Lou Reed song at the beginning of the show that you've never, ever heard in your life.
Lou Reed, Ronnie will do the whole Lou Reed thing justice.
Oh,
though.
Yeah, he'll do it justice.
No, he really will.
If you're a fan, yeah, that's what I mean.
He's a bandwagon Lou Reed fan. He just jumped on. It's popular.
And then people saying Lou Reed performed with Metallica recently.
Yes, they did a song or a record together.
How long ago?
Last year or 2 years ago?
Yeah, I don't know that either.
Yeah, no, I remember here we played it. We talked about it on the show.
Lou Reed and Metallica?
Yep. I don't remember what it is, but we did talk about it. They did a song with them.
What song did Lou Reed do with Metallica?
And I'm sure somebody on Twitter will accuse me of reading that and then trying to act like I just knew it.
And can we read Black Earl's tweets on Lou Reed? They're terrific, by the way.
Oh, God. Yeah, I'm never sure if an artist is really dead until I get the confirmation from Earl. Depressing Earl's Twitter feed.
We lost another one. Lost another one today.
A chorus of the voices. I gather up the magnets.
Oh, God.
Before me.
He makes Metallica suck.
I attract you and repel you. A science of the heart.
It's no different than when Shatner does it.
And Lou Reed is a shoehorn and motherfucker with lyrics.
And in a coffin, your soul shaking. I want to have you downing every meaning you've amassed, like a fortune. Oh, throw it away or worship someone who...
All right, so that's kind of spoken...
Yeah, just spoken word
with some music behind it.
A singer who can't fucking sing. Amazing.
A very distinct voice, though.
Yeah.
Oh, he sounds good now, though. Could you keep going, James, please?
What a great voice, huh?
Oh, he's fucking awesome, Hetfield.
Now back to old chit-chatty fucking Lou Reed.
Worship! Worship! Pain and evil.
He looks like Joe Piscopo.
Sitting here beside me, I offer them to you as servants of the gold that you must give. Pain and evil have their place. Sitting here beside
this
me.
This is drivel.
I
too cool for the room crap.
Yeah.
People who listen to this don't like it. They just like to say that they fucking listen to it.
Where's Hetfield?
Come on, James. Help us out.
What a powerful fucking voice Hetfield has.
Yeah, you realize, like, that's who should be fronting a band. I am the view, I am the table.
What the fuck are you saying?
Music's cool.
Of course. Then you get fucking Lou Reed yapping over the whole thing.
You don't like Lou Reed?
Yapping.
I gotta say, I don't mind this. I don't mind this. It's starting to grow on me a little bit.
I don't like Lou Reed's part.
Lou Reed's part. Dumb talking shit. Yeah, I don't mind it.
Like when Jim Morrison did it, didn't bother me. Like, I enjoyed his spoken word stuff they put music to. Because I know Jim Morrison gets sick. So when he did it, it was like a guy, an artist, just kind of departing. Like Lou Reed just kind of irritated me.
Yeah, Lou Reed's irritating.
All right, Lou.
What year was this? Like 90s?
No, it's just very recent. Like a couple years ago.
Really?
Yep.
The video looks very 90s. I think they were going for a Johnny Cash thing there.
I knew this was going to happen. We got the Defenders now.
Okay.
Dick Frank in New York.
Dick Frank.
I guess. Is that really your name?
What's happening, boys?
Hey, boy.
Hi, Dick.
Yeah, thanks. 75, Rock and Roll Animal, best live album ever made.
All right, 75 Rock and Roll Animal. Do we have anything off that album?
What's the big song off there?
Sweet Chain, Heroin.
Of course.
It's a Dope Shooters album, you know what I'm saying?
But do you really think Lou Reed's a good singer?
No, but the music was incredible. Okay. You had Stephen Hunter and Ian Hunter on the album. It was like a whole Mata Hopel thing. It was really good music, you know?
I wonder what it is about Lou Reed. I'm not going to say the guy sucks. He's obviously influenced a lot of people. But what is it about him that just grabs people?
He was a city minstrel guy, man. He was a fucking roaring guy. I hate that shit.
What is that?
A city minstrel guy.
What's that mean?
Oh, he's like wandering around the city, sharing his fucking craft.
The stories.
Oh, shut it.
See?
You fuck yourself. Go fuck yourself with Lou Reed's dead dick.
Jesus, man. What the fuck?
Anthony, you're the funniest fucking guy ever, man.
Of course I am.
What the fuck? Guy loves his Lou Reed. You don't like that he walks around the city and he might see things that we can't possibly see ourselves?
Of course not.
Finding art in the simplicity of people.
We don't have the fucking ability.
We just see a street and maybe a couple people walking around, but he sees a lot more.
Of course.
He sees life in those dark alleys.
That's right.
He's showing everybody.
He understands the people.
Ugh.
Because you know what? He takes that walk on the...
wild side.
Yes, he does. He dared to go places we wouldn't.
And the color girls go do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do.
You gotta love this one. No,
I don't.
You don't even like this one?
Jackie came from Miami, FLA. Hey. So it sounds like he's constantly trying to find the note.
From Miami, FLA.
Hey.
Hitchhiked away across the USA.
Hey.
Plucked her eyebrows on the way. Shaved her legs and then he was a she. She says, hey, babe.
I can't take a walk on the wild side.
A little tranny action.
Yeah, exactly. Hey, gotta respect Lou.
Way to go, Lou.
Attaboy, Lou. Pioneer.
God.
This is enjoyable, though. Like,
no.
From out on the islands.
Islands.
In the back room, she was everybody's darling.
Oh, he's terrible.
But she never lost her head, even when she was given head.
Oh, tee hee hee!
Can you pause there? It's a little rough when you rhyme head with head, though.
Yeah, yeah. Well, he's a genius.
Can you go back to that line?
Oh, senior editor of Rolling Stone magazine. Oh, I'm sure. I'm sure.
On his own terms and lived life on his own terms.
And didn't really care about the commercial success either, did he?
That's true, yeah. He constantly challenged conventions, whether it was experimenting with
challenge
guitar feedback
convention.
Or giving a voice to gay people and transgender people in his
means?
At a very at a time when that was really
taboo. I'm challenging convention.
Why is he so influential? Where do we see his influence?
Well, you can see Lou Reed's influence on a number of artists who have cited him specifically as an influence, people like Patti Smith, R.E.M., The Strokes. But beyond that, you can really see his influence on virtually anyone today who we consider
the
to be
Strokes,
indie rock,
one and done.
Punk rock, alt rock.
The one and done
the
band,
he sort
The Strokes.
Of challenged conventions and did things punk. His own way is a huge
example. First of
example
all, I haven't heard one example of Lou Reed and punk. Yeah. They talk about how he's the fucking pioneer godfather of punk.
Of time with him over the
I haven't heard one example
active.
Of a punk song out of this motherfucker.
Steven Tyler in his tweet referenced Maxis. That's Maxis, Kansas City. It was a salon effect. It was a bar here in New York City.
Steven Tyler's an idiot.
Into just like an idea factory.
Not for him.
As well.
There's rambling nonsense when he talks.
And he would often say that the music has to mean
something. Tells a lot of jokes when you talk.
You can't even fucking understand what he's saying.
Then really it loses its value, becomes a commodity. And that's rare. That's rare.
Yeah, that's absolutely true. Well, Lou Reed was
looks
certainly
like
an
big
activist.
Bitch doesn't like Lou Reed.
He was also an artist, as you mentioned.
Sitting there with their arms crossed.
He was very close to Andy Warhol in the early part of his career.
Like
he was one of the first examples of someone who showed that rock music and high art could kind of be one and the same.
And also the longevity, too, not just of his musical career, but as you said, the philanthropy, the activism.
They were still playing do-do-do-do-do on the radio.
Until recent days.
What longevity?
I understand he was a big fan of our guy, of Kanye.
That's right, yeah.
Which is interesting because that's such a
our
juxtaposition
guy, really.
In a way,
all right.
Yet not.
The black lady has to bring
actually,
in
that's right. Just
that.
A couple of months ago, Lou Reed wrote a really eloquent review about why he loved Kanye West's most recent album, and that might have surprised some people, but I think it actually made sense.
Yeah.
Like Lou Reed, Kanye is someone who challenges conventions, someone who does things his own way, and I think that's, you know, Lou Reed kind of saw a kindred spirit there.
What was, we know his influence on music,
spirit.
But what has he been doing
Kanye's
later in life?
Baby boy.
Was he in failing health for a long period of time? Do we know?
Well, he had a liver transplant this May, so we know that his health wasn't great. But he actually, you know, he remained active. Like I said, he published that Kanye West review just a couple of months ago. He made public statements. So this is certainly a surprise and a shock to everyone.
Well, it was really great for you to join us.
You know, that, you know, didn't want commercial success. But that's such bullshit. I'm sorry. You want another song like Wild Side. I guarantee it.
Stop it.
I hate when they make believe they don't want the commercial success. You might want to do a lot of things with your talent, but you definitely want, you know, the masses to hear your shit, right?
Jesus. There are guys not willing to sell out for commercial success, but you don't. There's no one makes a song and doesn't want it to be successful. That's a lie.
What they look at the numbers and go, oh, thank God, no one's buying this because I don't want commercial success.
Yeah. Please
what,
don't they get, listen
they,
to
they,
this.
They throw a party when it's a commercial
a flop.
Failure.
When it's a flop,
shut
they're
the
like, thank God, this is just what I was looking
right,
for.
Exactly. Or is that how you spin things because you're not getting the commercial success, and then you become cool for not having commercial success?
Then you use words like you're challenging convention.
Yes.
Eclectic.
Right. Get the fuck out of here.
You know what would be on?
You want commercial success so you can do those other things.
Exactly.
If they said they didn't have commercial success and he was okay with that and he didn't change what he did to get commercial, that's probably fair.
Yeah.
Like he didn't try to whore himself to get it.
Right.
Fair. But don't act like you didn't want it. That's
no, he wanted
bullshit.
It.
Of course.
Okay. But he wasn't going to, you know, Jimmy said it very, very well right there. Yes, exactly. It's a fine balance.
Yeah. I want to hear Sweet Jane from Rock and Roll Animal, which is right here. Sam has it.
You're not going to like it, though.
I want to hear what live sounds like.
Can you try to have an open mind?
I'll have an open mind, because this guy said, you got to listen. The guy that called before said, you got to listen to Rock and Roll Animal, best live album ever. Ever!
What about Peter Frampton Comes Alive?
Exactly.
That's voted number one all
the
time.
I hate that record.
No?
I don't
know if you... It's shit. Reunion is much better.
Yeah?
Yeah, that will annoy people.
All right, let's hear a little Sweet Jane. Could go to break with this.
No, I want to be able to say how much it sucks.
Yeah.
Let's hear a little.
All right.
See if live they punk it up a little more. A little volume on that? It's a little low. Ooh.
a little at first. Jam out.
Kind of like that. It's a nice sound.
It is a nice sound.
All right.
I'll give the band props. I kind of like the way that sounds. Doesn't sound like Lou Reed. Lou will come in and, you know, destroy the song. Sounds very of the time. Mm-hmm. Well, it sounds like Peter Frampton.
I like this. For real, yo.
In your groove, yo.
I like this.
Da, 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 da. All right. Where is it? Where is it coming?
He's doing H backstage right now, man.
Is that it?
Yeah.
All right, can they start with the singing? What the fuck?
Relax. Everyone's in a hurry these days.
Oh, yeah.
Just relax a little bit.
Got time for this shit.
Why? Don't you hear it building? It's nice. This is good stuff.
Uh-huh.
There we go.
This has a very familiar sound. I'm trying to figure it out, but I can't.
Well, it's been around forever. There we go.
It's almost a Who thing going on. There. Here it comes. Coming around. No. Oh, boy. Well, we were coming around.
All right.
I mean, musically, I like this.
It's amazing.
It's very good.
It really is amazing. I don't think I've ever heard this.
Like, they're very talented musicians.
I don't think I've ever heard the live version of Sweet Jane before.
There is a Who thing going on with this.
Yeah, absolutely.
It's kind of a Who sound.
What year is this?
I don't know.
90s?
No. This is earlier than that.
70s.
70s.
Here we go.
Oh, now they're like,
Lou Reed just walked out.
1975.
Lou Reed just walked out, everyone.
Those claps were dubbed in later, by the way.
If this wasn't Lou Reed, you'd say this sucks. You'd be like, this singer is terrible. Get a new singer.
Yeah, but there was a point he wasn't really Lou Reed yet. So what happened then?
The assholes liked him, I guess.
Yeah.
Day. Well, finally heard him sing. That's wonderful.
It's only half over.
Man.
We could keep going, no?
I wouldn't.
No?
I wouldn't.
There we go. Let's do Matt in Tennessee right here. Matt, what's going on, buddy?
Not much, gentlemen. Good morning.
Good morning.
I saw Mr. Lou Reed about 2 years ago, and he played at my Lou Reed. Damn, doesn't go very deep, but he played for about an hour on the spot, or on the spot, and lights came on, walked off stage, people started clapping for, obviously, Take a Walk on the Wild Side, did not come out, would not play the song.
Oh yeah, doesn't play his fucking hits.
The one song people would want to hear.
Right, right.
The one song that allowed him to buy some fucking, you know, penthouse somewhere.
Yeah,
you got to play the song. I hate when these guys do that.
It's annoying. Oh. It's annoying.
Unless you have so many hits, then you're like, wow, I can't play Walk on the Wild Side because I got so many other ones I got to do tonight.
Sweet Jay.
But they purposely do that shit. Radiohead with Creep, they refuse to play that.
Why would they?
There's a million examples of this. That's bullshit because most of the people are, you know, want to hear the goddamn song.
Radiohead's another band. I tried. Yeah, yeah. I wanted to like them because I know they're very respected. Yeah.
They've had a couple of songs that crossed over into like hit territory, and the rest is this fucking experimental sounding horse crap.
I think it's awful, and I wish I didn't think that. I tried.
Yeah.
Ugh. It just doesn't reach me. Sometimes
what
music
about
just,
fake plastic trees?
I don't know that one.
God.
What about Black Star?
Don't know it. Maybe I've heard it and didn't know.
To be fair, I like Radiohead's The Bends, thanks to Stephen Lynch. He turned me onto that album years ago. And then I'll handpick a few other songs. That's it for me. But The Bends, I love the fucking album from beginning to end.
Yeah.
From beginning to end, I love that album.
I wish I did because they're like a really, I guess, different than anything I listen to. But
yeah.
God, I tried to. I was
like, but then because of The Bends, I try to like listen to other albums and I just, not the same for me, man.
Yeah.
This is Radiohead right here.
Out on the horizon, out across the neon light.
Wow, very good.
Are the vocals recorded low?
Oh,
no.
The words are coming out, oh, and where are you now?
This is alright.
It's off The Bends. Obviously.
Alone on an airplane, falling asleep against the window.
I'm a crab! Do you know, I was going through those old tapes of ours, fast forwarding, finding certain things, and Mustard was one of the guys, and it just was making me laugh. So annoying Anthony gets.
I'm a snob.
You don't like the way he sings, though?
You know.
Well, the...
It's his own style.
Okay. Mustard wrote me the other day.
Did he?
Yeah, we keep in touch. And,
oh, yeah?
He told me... Uh-huh. I don't know if I'm... fuck it. He's going to be on The Voice.
Really?
Huh?
He said, what?
Yeah, Mustard's going to be on The Voice. He wrote me the other day. In January. So I don't know.
Yeah?
I don't know, you know, if it's just the auditions. I don't know if he's getting picked.
They asked him to do it?
Oh, yeah. So maybe he's so just...
He's probably doing a TV audition. Then they set it up. You know, he doesn't have to wait on the stupid... out in front of a...
Yeah, so...
arena line.
Our old pal, Homeless Mustard, is going to be on The Voice.
I just saw a video of E-Rock sniffing his toes.
Ugh.
And of him kissing Bobo on the mouth.
Isn't that great?
Oh, made God.
I think I got that video somewhere. I'll look for it.
I have it. I just watched.
Well, I think I might already have it up on my channel.
Stupid Bobo DMs me. Could you take down the naked picture of me? I was like, I didn't put up a naked picture of you, you dumbass.
Who put up a naked picture of Bobo?
I have no idea. It was like fucking him in the tub. He goes, the one in the tub is okay, but the naked what? I'm like, that's the only one I put up. There's no nudity in the picture I put up.
Anything that's up with him is blurred out.
Yeah, he's an idiot.
Vinny wants in so badly right now. Vinny at Staten Island. Go ahead, Vinny.
Fuck Lou Reed. Fuck Radiohead. Fuck Emerson, Lake, and Palmer and their fucking 45-minute bullshit interlude.
I understand
the
first.
Good for you.
I understand the first two, but we weren't even talking about Emerson, Lake, and Palmer.
Yeah, but just that whole
another pretentious fucking horse shit band
for 10 minutes. Fuck you, Emerson, Lake, and Palmer. Stick it up your ass.
Emerson, Lake, and Palmer is another one of those bands. You hear a song or two on the radio, and you go, "Wow, I want to see what these guys are about," and then you're very disappointed.
Oh, you're just wrapped up in a keyboard whirlwind as you're trying to fucking relax.
What other bands disappoint you after you hear their one song on the radio?
Yeah,
and you think they're going to be the greatest thing ever.
And they just suck.
The Pogues disappointed me.
Yeah?
I don't know. Like a couple of their songs, but I just can't go too deep with
them. That's off kilter, too, those guys. They're wacky.
Like, I really liked Shane McGowan. And then the more I've heard of him, the more I started liking the other guys, Irish guys, better. Like, right. Yeah, he was okay. But
I don't know much about the Pogues, either. I know you brought a few songs to the show.
Just from Anthony's brother, Joe, actually. I heard him playing in an aunt's house one time. It was... A Dirty Old Town. I'm like, I like that. What is that?
Yeah. That's a great song.
It's not even their song. It's like an old. But I couldn't get into a lot of their other... I would rather hear like Ronnie Drew or somebody else.
That guy needs a dentist.
Oh, I think he has teeth now, I heard.
Does he?
Yeah.
It's endearing.
Is it?
He knows he doesn't need teeth
anymore. It's endearing. That's hilarious. It's endearing.
But he can't sing though.
More bullshit words that people use.
Yeah.
Get your teeth fixed. Hey, can you go to Black Earl's Twitter? Because he had a lot to say about Lou Reed.
Oh, he sure did.
He liked him?
Earl likes to think he's like part of the New York fabric.
Black Earl is like the Grim Reaper's henchman. He fucking makes the announcements. He's his spokesperson.
Yeah.
He's the fucking, he's the Grim Reaper's fucking Jay Carney.
Black Earl used to be part of our show, I guess. I don't know.
Yeah, back in the NEW days.
He worked at NEW when we did, is what it comes down to. And we put him on the air from time to time. Yeah. And he's all about the music, man.
Oh, yeah. E-Rock, comment?
Before the Lou Reed stuff, a few weeks ago, Earl was going to different juice bars around Manhattan and explaining why the juice was so pure compared to what you buy in the stores.
That was who was he doing
Earl's
that for?
Doing
himself.
An investigative report.
He was just
report.
Going to juice bars.
Yeah, well, that's would be pretty obvious.
Earl Douglas for No One Cares.
Right. You got fresh vegetables and they're making juice out of it.
Yeah.
What do you think it's going to taste like? I think it's going to taste pretty fresh and pure.
He's busting those controversies wide open.
Right. Compared to something that they bottled, I don't know, a week ago, 2 weeks ago, and shipped to you. Yeah, I think it might be fresher, Earl.
I'm a big juice fan, if people need to know.
Oh.
Love a good juice.
Mark Spitz.
$8 for a juice, though, man.
Juice.
But that's the one you pull out, Mark Spitz?
He was great in his day. It's the only Jewish sports figure that's been in history for the past fucking 100 years.
No, there was that other guy.
Rod Carew.
Oh.
Well, the bit was to not name anyone there, Eric, but thank you.
But Eric did pull
for actually coming up with Rod Carew.
Eric's just this morning.
He's just ratting everyone out, and trampling over everyone's shit.
The bit, and bit here.
Literal joke guy.
Wasn't it obvious the bit was to never name another one but try? Who cares if Rod Carew is kind of Jewy?
E-Rock comes up with his knowledge.
He's just sad, too, because I guess some Simpson voice died over the weekend.
Oh, yeah, from the Newhart show.
We know it for the Bob Newhart show, of course, the secretary.
Marsha something.
Marsha Wallace.
Wallace, right.
Who was she in the Simpsons?
Edna Krabappel.
The teacher.
Krabappel.
Edna Krabappel.
Was that the only character the only character she did?
That was the only one.
Oh, God, she sucks. Simpsons have been on the air for, what, 50 years, and she couldn't come up with another voice for them?
Everybody on that show does, like, half the show.
A million.
Yeah.
Why did she only have one?
She sucked.
That's all they had her do.
It's not like Homer dropped dead. Jesus.
You're going to be just fine.
Don't sweat it.
What's Earl's tweet? You got to do the first one where he's going to have... All right, yeah, you know which one?
Yeah, it's just so pretentious because he is really acting like he's... the Twitter account for New Yorkers to follow.
Yeah, here it is.
R.I.P. Lou Reed. We'll have more later. Lost for words right now.
He's always lost for words.
And by the way, he's not lost for words.
That's another one of those dumb things.
Right.
You have nothing to say. That's poignant.
You're so grief-stricken, you're at a loss for words.
You can't even speak.
You didn't know the guy personally. How would you be lost for words? Yeah.
And we'll have more later, as if you're the news source.
Yeah. I better check in with Earl.
How many hours did he need for the next tweet about Lou Reed? He really thought it over.
How long were his words fucking gone for?
Yeah.
Well, the first one was 16 hours ago.
Okay.
Then he followed that up 16 hours ago.
Wait, I thought he was a little lost for words.
He found him real quick.
He found some words.
So. Within the same hour, he found words?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
All right.
Thank God.
Yes.
And what was that?
One of the best songs written ever about New York. Love you, Lou. You've earned your rest.
No one wants to earn their rest.
You want to earn your rest if you're able to wake up at some point.
Yeah, of course.
Fuck.
Love you, Lou.
Love you, Lou.
You've earned your rest.
Earned your rest.
You think Lou's fucking reading Twitter? Reading Earl's Twitter?
Oh, good. That's like Earl's saying is Jim Nortoning.
Stop romanticizing death.
Yeah.
What earned your rest?
Well, you just tuckered out.
All right.
From not singing?
Yes, he's reading Twitter and then saying, oh, good. Earl Douglas loved me.
Earl says I could fucking relax now.
Yeah. Sweet Jane.
What song did he mean was one of the best songs written ever about New York?
NYC Man.
Oh, God.
I never heard that. Is that, do you have that?
Sure. Let's hear.
Oh, this was another song about New York?
What Earl says is a... How long is this piece of shit?
What year is this?
It's from his 1996 album.
Oh, wow. Okay, maybe it's different.
It's a newer song.
So I'd walk the streets of New York again.
Yeah.
To see things we can't possibly have seen ourselves.
Oh, of course not. So you're ready to be enlightened about New York. All right, this is some jazz shit right here.
You like jazz?
I love it. It's my favorite type of music.
It can only lead to trouble if you break my heart.
Oh!
Accidentally crush it on the Ides of March.
No.
I'd prefer you were straightforward. You don't have to go through all of that. I'm a New York City man, baby, and say go and that is that. New York City man. Just say go and that is it. Oof. I'm a New York City man. You just say go and that is that.
You just say go and that is that. Earl's an idiot.
Complicated. To make up a lie that you'd have to remember and really why. I wouldn't want to be around you if you didn't want to have me around. I'm an M-A-N-N man. Blink your eyes and I'll be gone. M-A-N-N man. You blink your eyes, honey, and I'll be gone.
How does Earl say this is the best song about New York
that was ever written ever?
It's not.
Yeah, New York State of Mind, Billy Joel.
Made a pretty speech. But
New York, New York.
New York! Come on!
There's plenty of New York songs that... This isn't even the top million.
You know Ant's in a mood if he's preferring a Jay-Z song to this.
It's not Jay-Z's version I like.
Oh.
This is not the best song
Alicia
about New York
Keys
ever.
That she's singing.
This isn't even close!
Oh, look, he's all over the TV.
I know what the best New York song ever is.
What?
E-Rock, do you have it? We're back! Back in the New York room!
Yes!
We're back!
This is great!
Back in the New York room! Welcome back to the OBN Anthony Show!
To hear the Opie and Anthony Show 5 days a week live on satellite radio, online on your phone or tablet, or even on demand, go to SiriusXM.com. Also, interact with the Opie and Anthony Show on Twitter at Opie Radio, at Anthony Cumia, and at Jim Norton.